4 ingredients, no baking, the easiest dessert you can make for a busy weekend. Hi guys, I'm Laura Vitale, and on this episode of Laura in the Kitchen, I almost forgot who I was there for a second. We're making a Biscoff icebox cake. Now, icebox cake is just a fancy term for cream, cookies of your choice layered together. That's really all it is, and this is so easy. You will need heavy cream, some powdered sugar, you'll need Biscoff cookie butter, and you'll also need some Biscoff cookies. Now, you can actually use any cookies that you want. You can also take out the Biscoff and use Nutella. You can take out the Nutella and use peanut butter. I mean, by all means, you can do whatever your heart desires, but I love this, and I wasn't gonna actually make this recipe, but a lot of you have been requesting this since last year when I showed you how to make a Biscoff cheesecake. You wanted to make an easier version, so I don't think it can get any easier than this, but let's go, let's get it going. So what I have here is an 8x4 inch little loaf pan. I'm making a small one because it's quite rich. I just don't feel like you need that much of it when you go to serve it. I think that's the perfect size, but you can double the recipe and just make it in like a 9 inch springform pan if you want to. This is perfect for me. To it, you're gonna need some heavy cream. To the heavy cream, you'll need a little bit of powdered sugar. I don't need it just yet. I'm gonna get the heavy cream started. I want it to be a little thicker before I start adding some of the powdered sugar. So let's go. Add some powdered sugar. You don't need a lot because we're gonna add Biscoff. And the Biscoff is very sweet. To your whipped cream, you're gonna go ahead and add your Biscoff. You need quite a bit of it. I would say about 3/4 of a cup, and we'll save the rest of this for the topping. Get it off the spoon. I'm definitely gonna lick that when you're not looking, by the way. I am most 1,050% sure, certain that I'm gonna lick that as soon as that camera goes off. I'm gonna blend this in. Beautiful. Okay. Now, this is so easy, it's insane. You're gonna just line the bottom with your Biscoff cookies. Now this, remember, is gonna be your top. So, line that up real nice, like that. If they overlap a little bit, it is fine. I don't like any of those empty little pieces. So, cut them up. It's okay. It will be the top, but guess what? It's gonna be covered in Biscoff topping anyway, so you're not even gonna really see it. I just don't like any empty spots, you know? Just break them up, throw them in there. Do a layer of your cream. And you can repeat this process however many times you want, however big your container is. Probably gonna do this like 3 times. Let's do another layer. Perfect. Last layer, like that. Beautiful. Save that for me, once again. And then the last layer of cookies. Now this does have to get wrapped up. You gotta stick it in the fridge overnight. It needs a definite minimum of 12 hours. I like to take it for 24 hours. I just feel like it's really best if you give it quite a bit of time to settle and set and all that fun stuff, but definitely a minimum of 12. There we go. Just like that. Look at that. Don't say I didn't do this recipe perfect in terms of measurements and all. I wanted to use just one sleeve of cookies because I know how frustrating it can be when like a recipe calls for like 1¼ sleeves or something like that, you know? But you can just double all of this up and do it in a 9-inch springform pan. You'd be in business. I'm gonna throw this in the fridge. It's gonna be in there for 24 hours. I wanna show you what it looks like tomorrow. We're gonna pour some more Biscoff on top, a few berries, just because, you know, we're gonna try and be a little healthy, and then just dive right in. Okay, it's been 24 hours. I love the tip here about overlaying your pan with plastic wrap because it makes it really easy. I'll show you to, it'll help you, watch, it'll help you get this off really easily. Bada bing, bada boom, bang, bang, boom. Do you know what I'm saying? Like my good old friend Tony Soprano used to say. You know, I take a little bit more Biscoff. You don't have to because it's really rich and sweet as is. But to me, Biscoff is like, it's amazing. So I do take a little more. I melted it in the pan. But you can go ahead and just melt this in a microwave. This was only a quarter cup. And when you melt it, it really stretches it quite a lot. And it's absolutely phenomenal. Salivating just looking at this. And then I do have some strawberries just because I feel like this is begging for a little bit of color. let's face it, they're not going to really be the star of the show, but I do feel like this is quite honestly crying for some color. So if you want to, you can cut a few berries and place them alongside just to make it look like we tried. Do you know what I mean? At least we tried, right? But now we're going to have to just... We're just gonna have to give this a little bit of a cut. I don't have a, actually I have this, which is amazing. Okay. Now listen, you and I both know I am an eater, but when I tell you, you need to give people, oh yeah, the slightest little sliver. I broke that one a little bit, but that's okay. But you need to give people, this tiniest sliver. I mean, it's very good, but very, very rich. This can feed like 12 people because that's how rich it is. Phenomenal. Yes, very rich. I'm obsessed. Cookies, cream, Biscoff. What's not to love? LauraInTheKitchen.com for the written recipe. Hope you've enjoyed spending time with me. Make this weekend, and I'll see you next time. Bye.